Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, we're back in the office today. I want to thank all of my friends and MVPs who provided podcasts over the last 10 days. I hope you found that enjoyable. Also, you know, when I went to the sci-young thing on Monday for opening day of baseball, didn't realize that it had been raining there. I threw the microphone down in the ground, and of course, it completely trashed the microphone. So sorry for all the static on Monday. I have a brand new mic here today that hopefully will work, although I have to wear this stupid mic. But anyway, we're back to questions today. I have a lot of questions that came in over the last couple of weeks. If you have a question, please feel free to get it to us. Either leave us a voicemail or just drop me an email and we'll get to it. Today's question comes from Jason in the UK. Jason's getting stock quotes and the data comes into column A, and unfortunately it has 6 bits of information right in that one cell. And Jason just wants to grab the price out of there. So he wrote this formula he thought would work pretty well. The mid of A2 starting at position 13 for a length of 7, and sure enough that does grab the 552. But then Jason found that there were problems. If the quotes came in the morning, so let's say 11:35 a.m., that time took up one extra character, and so the formula didn't work. Or if there were other securities where the price was only 2 digits instead of 3 digits, then it's not working either. Now, the solution to this, unfortunately, is rather complicated. The first thing I did was I took a look through that data. I said, okay, right before every price, we have a colon. So if I could find the colon and then start to navigate from there, that would be the first step. Also, right after every price, we have a lowercase p. And so I used the find function. My first find function, when it initially worked, I said I want to find a colon within cell A2. And I was surprised that it gave me a character position like 4 or 5, because what it was doing was it was finding the colon in the time. And so I had to go to the third argument of the find function. This says, hey, start at position 7. That way I know that I'm beyond the time, but basically it allows the find function to find the colon that happens after position 7, and it says that it happens in character 12 or 13 or 12 in row 4. Basically it allows us to kind of hone in on where the price is going to start. We know that it's going to start a character after that position. I thought I was going to be in trouble when I was finding the P, because it might find the capital P in PM, but it turns out that the find function is case sensitive, so finding in quotes a lowercase p within A2 will tell me that that P occurs in character position 20. Then it's just a matter of, I'm going to take the mid of A2, I'm going to start at the position in B2 plus 1, so in other words start right after the colon, and then to figure out how far I want to go, how many characters to use, I'm going to take C2, that's the place where the lowercase letter P is found, minus B2 minus 1, because otherwise it would give me the P as well, don't want to do that, and enter that formula, and sure enough it works no matter what time it comes in, whether we have 4 characters in the time or 5 characters in the time, and also no matter what the price is, whether it's a security that is $1, $10, or $100, we'll still get the right value. So, unfortunately, it's not as easy as we thought, but by using a couple of find functions in combination with the mid function, we're able to solve this problem. Thanks to Jason for sending in this question. If you have a question, please feel free to get the question to us either on a voicemail or in an email, and we'll get to you on a future podcast. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.